On today's episode, we're going to be talking about things we all waste money on. If this is something you will benefit from, do keep watching.
I'll say subscriptions. So when I say subscriptions, I mean your music subscription, your TV subscriptions. Guys, I don't know why you would have Spotify, you have iTunes, you have Tidal, you have, I don't know. Why would you have so many music subscriptions, especially if you're paying for any of them? Also, your TV subscription. Why are you having Netflix at the same time, Amazon Prime at the same time? Stick to one TV subscription. If you have up to three TV subscriptions and you are actually catching up on movies and series on these things, you need to reaccess your life. What are you doing with your life? Knowing the end of a movie or the plot of a movie, how does it really affect you? Yes, I know there are some movies that are actually intellectual and sensible that probably give you a life skill or two, or know how people behave, you know, in some ways. But guys, you can be doing better things than watching, keep catching up with every single TV series. So just reaccess your pocket. It's like, let's say Spotify right now. Free version of Spotify only makes you start listening to ads and, you know, once in a while. My Spotify, I usually use it when I'm on a commute to work. So immediately they said lockdown 3 weeks, I went into Spotify, cancelled the whole thing, you know, and then I just started checking other unnecessary things I'm spending my money on. If the song is so important to me, I can download it. I know how music is, to be honest, moods and everything, but just cut it down. Have only one if it's really necessary in your life.
I don't know how it happens where you're based in, but here in the UK, most banks give us overdraft, and once you go beyond the allowed overdraft, there's fees incurred. Thankfully, right now, because of the situation, a lot of banks like HSBC have increased their limits. Like, they let you go up to £300 with no fees. That's good, but just going beyond your overdrafts and incurring fees is such an irresponsible way to manage your money.
In my books, overdraft fees are a no-no. Do not spend what you don't have. This one is really, really, really annoying. Game apps. In fact, why are you even buying a game? Sometimes the game is even free. You're not going to the game. Start playing the game. To get to the next level, you have to buy some coins. So you now use your real money in your bank that you worked hard for to buy token in a game, so that maybe the monkey would appear somewhere or you get to the next level. Like, I guess, be thinking. This kind of means are ways to just drain you for no sensible reason. Like, what's the value of that game in your life? The opportunity, because when you're spending something, just think of it. What am I actually losing by buying this thing, or what am I gaining by buying this? So you know how important it is. So all those in-game apps, please just delete. If the game is not free, delete it from your phone. Why are you even playing games up and down the whole place? Like, why are you so invested in a game that you have to start buying coins that are not real with your money that is real? Check it, please. Next thing I'll say is take away coffee. I know when you're working, when you get to the station, enter your train, I just want to buy one cup of coffee. Coffee. In fact, before you know, one day you've already drank three cups of coffee one day, even if you're drinking one. Why can't you go and buy the coffee in your house? Instant coffee is £1 for the whole jar. Normal coffee is like £3 something, £4. Buy the whole thing. Buy a cup which is even environmentally sustainable. You're taking care of your environment by having a cup that you're reusing and reusing. Make the coffee in your house. I have a jar of coffee in my office. Obviously, hot water is always free. So go there, put your coffee. If you need milk, usually most companies have milk. Or buy your own milk and then mix your coffee. Spending £3 every day on coffee, that's like £15. Let's say it's £2 in the, it's just an average, because obviously Starbucks is not £2. So an average of £2 every day, Monday to Friday, that's already £10. For what? And then that's even when you're buying one. So guys, buying coffee every time, ordering coffee up and down the hoop is take away coffee. If you actually look at it sensibly, it's actually a money waster. Okay, the next one. Have you ever been hungry that you just go to order food, and then before you know, you're ordering food for like five people, for just yourself, or let's say like three people, because you're very hungry? I always encourage people to try as much as possible to cook. This lockdown now has helped a lot of us finesse our cooking skills. Just learn how to cook, meal prep. Those things go a long way. Like, ordering food every day for lunch, ordering food when you're just crazily hungry, it's not the way to go. You would spend your money stupidly. I was watching this documentary on Patricia Bright's The Break Platform the other day, of the girl who earns $210,000 a year in dollars. This girl still shares a house. This girl spends $300 on herself, her needs monthly. You know, she still cooks. Her and her friends come together to cook. Like, you guys, you have to respect your hustle. You can't be money, except you get money from, I don't know, the tree, or I don't even know how free it comes to you, because really there's nothing like a free lunch. Respect that paper. Make it work well for you. Don't be spending it on things that are frivolous, thinking you have arrived. I understand you trying to improve your lifestyle at some point when your earnings increase, but do it smartly. I don't really understand why, you know, you spend money on a habit that doesn't really add anything to you. Instead, it actually destroys your insides. Like, why would you be spending so much money smoking, some of you now call it vaping. Vaping, I don't even know. Both of these habits have no space in your life. I know nicotine and this addiction can make things really difficult to stop, but guys, you're wasting your money. Okay, maybe when you guys go outside to smoke with friends and everything, the banter you have is nice. Yes, I understand that, but in the end, you buy the packet. In 2 days, that packet has already finished. Some people tell you they're smoking because the weather is cold. In the sun, you still see them downstairs smoking. So just try and check that habit. I know when it comes to smoking, it's not something people tell you to stop and you have to stop. It's a decision you have to make. But yeah, just look at it 2 ways, and it's not good for your health and it's not good for your pockets. Next thing I'll say is the extended warranties on gadgets. These days, the way gadgets even come and go, like if something has lasted so long that it had to spoil, repairing it sometimes is even more than buying a new one. So you can have the first warranty, but just reconsider those extended warranties these companies try to sell to you, to making you pay more and more money in just one gadget you have. Then coupons. You know how you get a coupon and you now start trying to get more coupons so you can go and buy something. That doesn't make sense. If you needed it, you would have the money to buy it. Having coupons sometimes, these companies and brands just make you want to find a way to come and spend again. Sometimes you finish buying something that in a place, maximum, the lowest amount of what they sell there is like £15, and they give you a coupon of £12. What do they want you to do? To add another £3 or even add more money just to keep buying things? So don't get carried away with the value you think you're getting from gathering coupons or trying to spend the coupon and stuff like that. Except it's something you really need that is really ideal. Yes, you can keep your coupons because obviously you need it the next time. But don't get carried away with things that, you know, are supposedly free. There's nothing like a free lunch in this world. But this one is something I really like, energy drinks. Guys, have you ever tried energy drinks and how long did they last in your body? Like, they can just give you one vibe or buzz for like 1 hour and that's it. And those things are not good. Apparently, the things they use to make energy drinks are not even good for the human body to keep consuming it over and over again. So if energy drink is something I can stop, I would gladly stop it because it doesn't add any value to my body. It doesn't add any staying power to me being awake. If it's time to sleep, then sleep. Or rather, you train yourself to stay awake for the amount of times you want to stay awake for. Next is luxury goods. The only thing I'm going to say about luxury goods is that just know the reason you're buying these things. And then finally, the fact that you can actually buy something doesn't mean you can afford it. You'll laugh now when I say the next one. The next one is cheap stuff. Yes, I know I'm telling you, you don't have to kill yourself buying luxury goods to impress any motherfucking soul. Cheap goods, guys, on the other hand, are not even the best because you end up buying like 3 times what you should have bought, a quality stuff. So instead of going luxury, just buy something of good quality. There are a lot of things that are good quality that you're not spending, wasting money on. Going back to luxury things, a lot of luxury things we buy, we actually pay for the marketing. You buy a bag today from the store, as you tear the bag of that luxury bag, the price has gone down almost to half of it. Why? Because you're actually paying for the marketing. You're paying for the fact they've done so many advertisements. You're paying for that feel of, oh my god, I opened a new, you know, they would call it pre-owned, used, just because you opened the bag. Jiggers. Going back to cheap stuff, just try and keep its quality, because there's no point buying something you have to now be buying again because you bought rubbish the first time in the name of cheap. You'll now be penny wise, pound foolish. So just consider both ends of the spectrum. The next one is splurging on baby clothes. I know you're going to see your kick, and the way, in fact, when you're even buying clothes for people's kids, like baby girls especially, oh my god, you want to buy everything. So while you're having all that muji feelings in your mind, try and keep your cost low, the prices of things you're buying. These babies outgrow these things so fast. A lot of babies don't wear their outfits more than twice. Do you get? So what's the point buying the high brands? Keep it calm, and I would even say cheap when it comes to buying baby clothing. Keep it moderate when it comes to the toys, because a lot of toys, you know, actually help them put it in their mouth. It helps them go through different stages of their lives. So, but when you're buying baby clothing for your baby, other people's babies, calm down. Next is beauty products. Your favorite influencer comes out today. This size shadow is now the one. In fact, it's actually making you see into the future. This lipstick, what should talk? In fact, everybody's going to do what you say they should do. There are 1,000,001 brands out there, guys, with a lot of them offering the same thing. Don't get carried away. Stick to what works for you. If you're having a certain problem right now, okay, maybe address the problem. But trust me, these things will never end. It will never end. Today, they'll tell you this is the one you're wearing in spring. Winter. change your lipstick. How can you be wearing the same eyeshadow in summer? You know, there's just everything everywhere. It's even difficult to tell who is saying the truth, who is lying, because everybody is just being paid to say something. Just hopefully, by God's grace, okay, maybe you find a dermatologist, or just find what works for you. Usually, a routine works, though our faces and skin sometimes get bored of this routine. I'm going to tell you guys my own journey at some point, but yeah, just don't get carried away with what people are saying. Know what works for your face, stick to it as minimalistically as you can. A lot of natural remedies can do a lot of things, all these products do on your skin. So do your research to a good extent, and then, yeah, cut down on spending money on every new thing that pops your timeline, your feed, your faces. Yeah, the last thing I would say is keeping money in the bank. Oh my god, that's like the most fraudulent way to say you are saving, because the bank rates, oh my god, yesterday I got an email from Metro Bank saying the government have reviewed something, now your savings account rate is no more 1 point something, now 0 point something. Kidding me, guys. If you want to save, please run away from your bank savings account. Apart from the fact that you still have full access to that money, which means the next person that begs you, you're going to bring it out from there to give them, and then you too, you'll do your frivolous beauty products, that nonsense that you're buying, luxury, it'll be from there. You just quickly grab the money. So please, if you're thinking of investing, do things like stocks, treasury bills, bonds, fixed deposits. There's this one in Nigeria now, they call PiggyVest. I know most of my currency is in pounds, but I'm really looking towards that way, because I just like the idea of every day you're saving 1,000, every day you're saving 1,500. At the end of a month, 30 days, like, do you know how much you get? At the end of the year, do you know how much you'll be looking at? So I'm really, really considering that PiggyVest, because I think they'll be taking money from your account monthly or daily or something. And then at the end, I think you tell them when you need your money back, or when they should not give you the money. If you want to take it before, then they'll probably charge you or something. But that's just a lovely and more structured way to save. And I'm sure there are other ways than bank savings accounts, but that's just the highest for, because you have access to the money and the interest rate is trash. Yeah. So guys, please, if there are any other ways you know that we all waste money on, or you personally waste money on, or you think other people waste money on, please drop it in the comment section. I would really love to read from you. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope this video will make you make some lifestyle changes that are beneficial for yourself right now and in the future. Guys, when you watch those documentaries of girls and boys that are our ages and are saving, and you just be like, what have I been doing? Like, these people are earning so much money, but a lot of it goes into stocks, go into investments, go into so many things, like for the future. You know, we're all supposed to be independent ladies. I know this video is not for ladies only, but it's always lovely when you see your fellow girls like grinding. And thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to join my family. When you subscribe, click the bell right beside the subscribe button as well. Drop a comment, because I really love to read from you. And then if you're tired, you don't see any of these things, just click the thumb up button. See you on the next episode, guys. Bye bye.